reading from Revealing the Hidden. As we complete 1 year of this particular YouTube channel, today we are going to start with the next series, which is very important for everyone's life, that is marriage. As we know that marriage is prestigious when we talk about the society or when we talk about any culture, we can understand the number of divorces are also increasing. So let's start from the scratch, what marriage is, and we welcome all of you to put your comments in the comment box if you have any topics to be addressed. So to start with the topic, I present myself with my wedding sari so that the aura of that auspicious occasion can be represented. And we have wonderful integrity to be a part of this session. Welcome, Bonnie, to the new season of marriage. So the question come to you is, what is marriage?
Thank you again for inviting me. And I think it's a joy that, you know, we are firstly celebrating 1 year of having, you know, God giving us words of wisdom and new world viewers. So I'd like to give you thanks to, you know, being following with us. And we're starting with this new season of with topic called marriage. I think marriage beautifully starts with the beginning. So for me, marriage is where it's not that everybody has to get married to complete life, but marriage is the completion in itself, in a way where two people come together and they don't come together just by their own understanding or wisdom or knowledge, but they come together by the ordination or by the way of the Creator. In a sense, the Creator brings these two people together. That for me is marriage, because marriage is not a linear line between point A and point B. It is more like a triangle with him at the apex and two people being joined together.
Very nicely explained, Bonnie. To add on to that, I want to tell that marriage is a milestone for anyone's life. Nowadays, marriage is seen as a party or an occasion to celebrate. But for me, I think about a person's afterlife for a prolonged time. We are not only focusing on the short goals. We need to think about how they're going to face the havoc throughout their lifetime.
Correct.
So marriage is something, as previously people see, it's a traditional thing, holy thing, and both the parties, the husband and wife, need to be prepared to submit to each other, to be a team, what you're explaining before.
Correct.
So who's the husband, Bonnie, according to you, in a marriage?
A good question. A husband is someone who is submitted,
right?
Someone who is, you know, he's not just a leader, but he's also somebody who leads by example. And I think in a marriage, both the roles of the husband and the wife are very complementary.
Right.
So certain things that is expected of a husband is also expected of a wife, and it's vice versa. For example, while the husband steps out to work, or, you know, in today's situation or in today's time, both the husband and the wife step out to work, both of them need to know that, you know, the husband is still the head of the house.
Right.
There was a time when, you know, in a patriarchal society where only one person would go out to work in the company, the husband, so he would be the earning member in the house. He would get bread from outside, and, you know, he would get everything in the house. He would be the provider per se. But today that is changing. But in this changing moment as well, the way for me to look at is, you need to just have one leader in the house. Though you have, you know, a common voice, and though you have a democratic kind of a way, I would always be following one specific person, because if you have multiple leadership in the house, which keeps changing from one person to the other, the house will not be able to stand. It's like, you know, the steering wheel, both have to go together. But if one says left, the other says right, the car will either be stuck or will be without wheels. Same way, if one is on the driving seat, the one has to be on the driving seat. So for me, when you ask me husband, I would say he is the driver. But he also needs to have a car to have the wife with him, because driving alone is not fun. So So I think he needs to also ensure that he's not driving solo. So while he's a driver and while he's in the driving seat in leadership, he also needs to be acceptable of the fact that he's leading someone. So he needs to also keep his mind on the back, saying that, oh, I have somebody else following, which means if my wife is not following or if my wife is not being along with me or I'm not able to lead in that way, I need to stop, pause, ensure there are any problems. And that's why I always say that husband is also the problem solver. Both are, but husband also, because he looks at the road ahead, he looks at a lot of things ahead. And I think both husband and wife need to have roles of accountability, responsibility, communication, those kind of things. But I think husband is the initiator, because you always see, you know, husband is the one in movies, you know, husband is the one who goes on his knees. And that act for me is very respectful, because the husband submits before getting the wife as his companion. So I think there itself, that image itself tells us what the husband's role is. Not always on his knees, but one hand ready to take care of the wife.
Beautifully explained. I really loved the way you explained what it was. It's beyond explanation, the way you said it's very nice. So I would like to comment the role of a husband as nowadays women or girls have some kind of notions, the so-called man or a husband having six packs or having a beard or good looks and hair. These are the highlights of a husband. But no one is understanding, or the women in the reproductive age, I mean to say maybe from their adolescent to the time they're getting married, they're not understanding there is a life beyond these looks.
True.
And people are seeing on the photos are not the real people. Or the dates what you are going to have is not the real person. They are doing their best at that time. But I want to say that beyond the looks or the job or the house they are coming from, really these two parties should learn who is supposed to get married to her. That means what is the wife expectations. Better talk to each other and what they want, and try to see whether you are able to fit into that particular the responsibilities. And as days goes by, see, when you get married, you are not matured enough to understand, are we able to tackle the further things. So more than the looks or the money, the assets you have, is he patient enough, or is he able to take care of me? So these are the things a husband should have. You spoke much beyond what I said.
I think I want to add on to that. I was reading somewhere on social media that, you know, young girls especially, their mindset when they look at men is, you know, the outside. But slowly and steadily, as a woman matures, or as the opposite gender matures, they start to realize that the outside is for a limited time, and it starts to change. So that maturity, I think, when people reach that level, automatically the outside, even if it is there, it's an add-on. But they realize that there is more to a person than just the face, or just, you know, the body, the weight, the height, and the way the language is. Because that maturity creates in a woman, or also in a man in that way, a notion to know that life and a person is way beyond the personas, outside persona.
To add in one more point, if you are asking about my marriage, I met my Jones only once, and directly we were getting married after 2 weeks. And when I saw him, you know, he's short and he is healthy and he was bald. And I did not find these are the lacunas in him as such. I don't know why. I was only 24, and now I'm not telling I'm mature to see my life after marrying him, no. But I couldn't, at that age or so, I couldn't felt that was the important things to be considered. And today I completed my 12 years of marriage, and I don't find I took a wrong decision. So I mean to say, I'm not saying there is no problem, there are problems, there are conflicts, but we grew over that so we can have a better married life. So I think looks is not everything life is much beyond that.
Very true, very true. And the more we talk about marriage, it's marriage is one of those topics which, you know, you can keep talking about, but I think it starts with doing, because I think the crux of marriage is human relationships. So if at all, when a person looks into the mirror and does not like what he sees, he may not be able to receive the love in marriage and also through the opposite gender and also through his own partner. So I think marriage is also about loving each other and each component, which also starts with you. So the marriage that happens and the marriage that breaks, there is one commonality is, you know, people when they get together, they say there is alignment, there is a match, and when they separate, they say now we don't align. So what happened during that phase? It just happened that they couldn't accept that somebody who matched now did not. It was basically, we all change, we all evolve, but marriage is like the bond that holds us together as we evolve. The tires of the car, I love the example because it kind of gives a nice pictorial view that even though the tires keep, you know, when the car has been driven, the vehicle has been driven, the tires keep getting bald and bald, the threading of the tires change. We don't change the car, what we do is we change the tires. In the same way, the entire axle remains the same. Okay, it's just the outer tire that changes, which means when we wear out, we just need to change the outer part of it. But the crux remains the same, the marriage crux remains the same. So I would like to ask you, what according to you would be a good wife or a ideal wife?
Pani, no one to say that who is an ideal wife or good
the role
wife.
Of a wife, yeah.
Yes. When before I was getting married, people said that the wife need to cook, wife need to take care of children. It's like I felt that marriage is like it's a big package on my shoulder. I really thought that is the way I saw in the society where I grew up, and that is what it is told to me. But when I entered marriage, it was a havoc because my husband was born and brought up abroad, and I'm from a village. We really took time to adjust to each other. But one thing I learned from my marriage is the roles and responsibility is not gender based. Who does the work will always be better. Suppose than me, my husband cooks better, and he does with passion. Majority of the wife cooks in the house just because it's a responsibility to do it. But when work comes out of passion, it tastes better, it looks better. So this is what I learned. That doesn't mean that he's inferior to me, no. As you said, he is the head of the family. That is the way culture spoke. That is what our religious values speak. So whatever a husband speaks, one need to be submissive. So it's always good that wife needs to be, they can share each other. One thing I always appreciate with my husband is whatever decision he takes, he asks me and take. It is not because he cannot take. That is the way it works. Even I take a decision, I tell everyone, let me talk to Jones. So this is the way, and by the end Jones will proclaim the decision in public because he's the head of the family. And I believe that is the correct way. So people will understand whom to ask what. And marriage is not really about the cooking part. Any decision, marriage is much beyond cooking, much beyond everything. Actually, I grew in that marriage. I was telling the editor who was doing my photo shoot, when I got married, I wore the sari. And today I wore the sari. I myself remembered how I grew myself in marriage. So as days goes by, a wife and a man should be willing to groom themselves so that as days goes by, the marriage is more colorful.
True.
So that whatever pains or gains you have, it is ours, not mine. And this way, if a wife is able to start the marriage, they are able to
stand
for a long time. I think we have spoken enough for the introduction of marriage. Next week, we are coming up with another interesting topic here. We are planning to discuss various matters, what we can see in marriage. So till we meet in the next session, stay happy and stay safe. Thank you.